The Lands Minister, Judith Navakova, emphasized the importance of the new policy. She noted that the policy's primary objective is not only to benefit specific individuals, but also to assist the government in acquiring land for its developmental projects.
You talk about disputes, land evictions, land grabbing. This calls for everyone's involvement, not only the ministry. The ministry, we are at the policy level, but remember, evictions happen in communities where we have LCs, where we have government workers, where we have RDCs, meaning that the duty bearers in those respective areas have also to wake up and do their work as expected by government, but also from the communities they are serving.
Naomi Kavanda, the acting director of lands management, emphasized the need to address the challenges that have been identified in the current policy.
We shall be able then to draft the next national land policy for the next 10 years, having looked at where are the challenges and how to address them, and where are the opportunities, and those we shall look at, and then new areas of reform.
Dorcas Okalany, the permanent secretary, the Minister of Lands, Housing and Urban Development, shared plans to incorporate the customary land tenure system into the land information management system. The integration aims to improve the guidance and productivity on these lands.
The platform will identify the gaps where we have issues. And remember, our population is growing very fast. Our ladies are very productive, including the men. Our birth rate is very high, about 3.5%, which is almost the highest in the world. And land in Uganda does not grow, but we have to manage it well and manage it for our citizens without causing a lot of havoc. We want all Ugandans to be productive, and in order to be productive, we have to manage it well.
Additionally, James Galabuzi, the chairperson of the Uganda Land Owners Association, criticized the previous policy of having loopholes and not adequately addressing serious challenges and considering the perspective of landowners.
Getting a win-win. The moment a policy is put in place with a hidden, pro certain sector, it will never work. So what our idea is, and what we would like to appeal to the powers that be, is that we should by all means have a win-win, a situation whereby a landowner and the tenant on land can coexist.
The proposed changes and enhancements in the new policy demonstrate a comprehensive effort to address various issues regarding land valuation, management and conflict resolution, while also considering the needs and perspectives of landowners across the country. Report compiled by Sharon Navasidie for the news.